Morning, everyone. You know, millions of Americans remain out of work, and the cost of groceries, gas, and health care continues to rise. The president's announcement yesterday of essentially a national energy tax and a continuation of the war on coal will only make matters worse, putting thousands and thousands of Americans out of work, increasing the cost of electricity, especially in a state like mine in Ohio, where about 95% of our electricity comes from burning coal. And he's looking for another excuse to not approve the Keystone Pipeline. Listen, all of this is making matters worse. The president's policies are not helping the economy. They're making it worse. And if that's not enough, we're about to see student loans double. The House has done its work. Senate Democrats and the president continue to stay on the sidelines. What we passed in the House was very close to what the president offered in his budget. It's time for the president and Senate Democrats to help lead.
Morning. Increasingly, the American people are losing trust in their government and losing faith in our economy. And these are the problems the House Republicans are trying to address and trying to fix. But the president of late has been largely silent on issues of great consequence. He's been relatively silent on Syria, on the question of the NSA, on the question of how we're going to get people back to work and create more jobs. But yesterday, the president took time out to announce that he will unilaterally introduce new rules and regulations that will impose higher energy costs on our small businesses and our working families, depressing growth in our economy, and just making it more difficult for the people of this country. We House Republicans reject this path. We passed bills and will do so again on two offshore energy bills this week to advance our all-of-the-above energy approach and to increase jobs and lower costs for working families. That is what it's about. That is a priority for House Republicans. If you look at the student loan issue, similarly, House Republicans have acted. We don't want student loan rates to increase, but yet the Senate and the President have refused to come together and join us to make sure that these rates don't go up on the students of this country. They should accept our plan. The President had a plan that was very close to ours. We could and should get this done for the students of this country. And finally, in the House, we're going to continue to work on our very deliberative approach of oversight and investigation into what's going on at the IRS. No administration should be allowed to use the neutral instruments like a tax enforcement agency to go after their political opponents. We're going to get to the bottom of this so we can tell the American people exactly what happened to work to restore their confidence in this government. We've got to do that. We've got to restore their trust in Washington, in this government, and we've got to restore their faith in our economy.
Good afternoon.
Morning.
It's morning for him. Well, I'm on California time. Maybe it should be morning. I get up earlier than him. I don't know. All right, enough of that. Most fun you had all day, right? Look. You've heard from the speaker, you heard from the leader. One thing that we have inside the House Republican caucus is a group called HEAT, the House Energy Action Team. If you've been paying attention, you've been watching on the floor throughout the year that our focus is to make America energy independent. With that, it lowers prices, produces more manufacturing jobs, and keeps America's money inside America. We've done hydropower, Keystone Pipeline. This week, with the leadership of our chairman, Doc Hastings, we've got two more bills coming. The ability for offshore. These are areas that were available when the president took office, but he shut it down. We think America should determine their own destiny. And we also believe that we think America should grow in jobs, and that's what we're working on the floor.
Back in 2008, the president promised millions of jobs from clean energy. And at the end of his first term, we saw the economy shed about 500,000 jobs, a lot of them due to just overregulation. And House Republicans are determined to stop shedding jobs. His announcement yesterday that we'd have additional red tape coming in, that he was going to declare a war on coal, is the wrong direction to go. I read yesterday 76% of Americans are living paycheck to paycheck. And when you increase the cost of energy, make it harder for employers to give raises and to hire that next employee, that's going the wrong direction. So hopefully House Republicans will act this week to go in the right direction so that we can get this economy moving and people back to work and make their lives easier, not more difficult.
There couldn't be a more stark contrast than the president's announcement yesterday with his war on coal and his tax on energy than what we are going to have on the floor this week with the offshore energy bill and the transboundary energy bill. Why do I say that? Because the greatest potential resources we have in this country for energy production, and energy production is important for a growing economy, and because of the good-paying jobs that are associated with the energy business. If we're going to have a growing economy, we have to have a stable and certain energy policy. Since the president took office, energy production down in offshore, in oil production, is down 12%. And natural gas production offshore is down 40%. Yet the president, in his announcement yesterday about a veto threat to my bill on the offshore, says that we have increased more energy production in this country. It's true, but it's not because of the energy policy of this administration. It's in spite of, because most of that energy comes from private lands and state lands. But we have to, I believe, make sure that we utilize all the potential resources on federal lands. And this starts with the offshore bill that we'll have. Very similar to what we had in the last Congress that passed with bipartisan support. And I suspect, again, it'll pass with bipartisan support.
Good morning. I'm Shelley Moore Capito, representing the great state of West Virginia. It's no mystery why I'm here today to talk about the president's speech yesterday. Essentially, what the president said to our country and to the state of West Virginia is just turn your lights out, West Virginia. We're over 96% of our energy generated is from coal. And we also are the second largest coal producer in the country. We export tons of coal across this world and keep the lights on here in our country. But what he has said is he's going to pick winners and losers. He hasn't taken into consideration the jobs impact, the economic impact of a state like West Virginia. And I'm very disturbed by his ability to segregate the country into certain winners and losers. And so when I think about the people who live in West Virginia, the miners that are there, companies that support the mining industry, the elderly couple that can't even meet the obligation of paying their electric bill now, and with this essentially a tax on their utilities, it will make it impossible for folks like that to meet their monthly obligations. I think that there's a better way. There's an all-of-the-above energy policy. The chairman has talked about the bills that we're going to have on the floor today. And I think that it is very short-sighted for the president to say to a state like West Virginia, thanks for your contributions. Thanks for your contributions to the manufacturing sector of this country by using your resource. But you know what? We don't need you anymore, and you can just turn the lights out, West Virginia.